Ah, Aveline. Good day. I have a surprise for you. What do you think? To the unknowing eye, an unassuming warehouse. But to our brotherhood, your new headquarters. Agati takes his office in the swamp. But we thought you might prefer this for your business dealings. From this desk you can manage, or better still, expand your family's trading empire. This room is all yours. And all of your guises are kept here. Over here, you have a private place to change your guise. And most importantly, your weapons and tools will be kept here. It is to your liking, then.
It's perfect.
In that case, I will leave you a quiet moment to familiarize yourself with everything. Aveline, I've, concocted a special instrument for you.
A parasol? I suppose I should thank you, but...
Allow me to, demonstrate. See? Elegant and deadly. Just like my lady.
Monsieur Blanc, you do know me so well.
Ah! Right. So... Business. Do you recall our rival, Monsieur Boucher, who was twice caught watering his wine?
Up to his old tricks again?
Now he claims our coffee erodes the nerves. He has erected a stall in the market by the docks and distributes handbills to that effect. Sales are impacted, and we have enough trouble keeping money in the company as it is.
Say no more. I'll see to it that he ceases his slander.
Salut. Aïe. Oui.
Bonjour, très cher.
Follow me.
The Grand Prix Coffee produces hives about the face and causes fit men to walk with a limp. Avoid the primitive muck water! Drink fine East India tea, the elixir of gentlemen!
What's the meaning of this?
I don't know, ma'am. They pay me to say what I'm told. I can't even read, I swear.
Where is your employer?
At his warehouse, no doubt. Please don't hurt me.
Kill me! What do you want?
Stop slandering the Grand Prix's reputation. Close your deceptive booth, clean the market of your insipid handbills, and issue a public apology.
All right! I'll apologize! I swear!
What's this? Coffee? How are you feeling? A touch nervous? Itchy?
All right, look. I'm desperate. I can't keep my slaves from escaping. I lose money every day, and all my stock is in tea. If everyone starts drinking coffee, I'll be through.
Anyone who keeps slaves deserves to lose them. Next time, remember, far worse things can haunt a man than lost business.
All right, ma'am.
He'll be no more trouble.
I'll say. He's going bankrupt, selling off his shops. Care to, expand your empire?
Now there's an idea. If I buy him out, I can pay his slaves a wage and set them on the path to freedom.
Certainly a more peaceful solution to your usual method of handling slavers. I'll keep a tally of properties available to buy and make sure my informants keep an eye on opportunities. Look for them.
Thank you, Gerald.